I can remember a time where there wasn't the internet. That was just 20 years ago, right? Sounds like a really long time, but in each of our lifetimes, that felt like it happened very quickly.
As one of the experts in the industry, how do you answer the question in sort of simple terms, what is blockchain?
The easy way to think about a blockchain is that it's a digital ledger. If you think of today's world, you have an Excel spreadsheet, you fill in some data. If I want to interact with you, suddenly I have two spreadsheets. And then you add some data to it, you send it back to me, and now we have like double the number of spreadsheets. And then we have to reconcile our points of views based on who has the most updated spreadsheet. Blockchain is just the next evolution where we can still have that real-time update, still feel like we're working on the same spreadsheet without requiring a third-party intermediary.
All right, so it isn't a simple one-liner answer.
That was as simple as I could make it.
Very good. FOMO.
FOMO. So fear of missing out.
A lot of times when I'm talking to corporate treasurers, they may feel like they're missing out on blockchains. What's your perspective if you were to talk to a set of treasurers and they feel like maybe they're behind?
I think that it's a misconception that everyone needs to have their own blockchain. Right. Not everyone does. I think the important thing to understand about blockchain technology is that it requires a network of participants. No one should be blockchaining by themselves. The power and the potential of blockchain comes from connecting a network of participants to share in both read and write data together. It will take some time for it to really come to fruition and normalized in everyday use, but the transformative impact of that can be enormous. I would say that from an internet point of view, we're still at the point in time where we thought it was a good idea to just put newspapers on internet browsers and read them on the internet. But obviously, as we know, it has evolved into something much more than that. There's now e-commerce, there's now mobile, and there are things that are happening now enabled by the internet that we never would have imagined 20 years ago.
If we think about this from a corporate finance team standpoint, what sort of areas do you see blockchain having applicability, and what are some of the use cases?
The origins of blockchain, as you know, are with Bitcoin. And so when our blockchain program was started 3 years ago, obviously the first use case that we started looking at was payments. But what we found was that the actual mechanism of payments clearing and settlement in today's cross-border world actually works fine today. What the technology inspired us to do was to really understand when there is cross-border payment slowdown, what is the root cause of that? And we realized that there were obstacles and challenges around the exchange of sanction screening information that held up the ultimate payment. That led us, as the blockchain team, to partner with the Treasury Services team to build a peer-to-peer network of correspondent banks to exchange sanction screening information. This is called the Interbank Information Network. Basically, we're able to take down a process that takes a couple days to maybe even 2 weeks to something like a few minutes.
If we take it up a level and think about, you know, finance more broadly.
One of the use cases that we're really excited about is around using blockchain to optimize the debt issuance and lifecycle management and handling process. You create the debt instrument and you distribute it, it settles automatically, and then automatically gets serviced by the technology itself. Something that requires redundant processes and calculations can just be streamlined and automated with smart contracts and blockchain.
Is there an easy way to give folks an idea of what a smart contract is?
First thing to note is that a smart contract is definitely not smart, nor is it a contract. Smart contracts just refers to business logic executed synchronously across all of the participants on the blockchain network. So actually, if you want to go back to the Excel visualization, you can think about them as just macros, but that doesn't sound that cool. So smart contract sounds way better.
If again we think about, you know, corporate treasury standpoint, if they wanted to start to embark on, you know, engaging more directly, what would you sort of recommend as next steps for them to think about?
Yes, I would definitely recommend that corporate treasury teams get educated about the technology. I think it's important for them to understand how this technology may impact their existing business models or their existing operational processes, where there may be opportunities for new markets or better processes. I think that for some teams that are more enterprising, there's the opportunity to get hands-on experience with blockchain through prototyping a project. The one thing that I would suggest is that you should make sure that when you work on a blockchain project, that the project itself is anchored in trying to solve a very specific problem or is addressing a very specific pain point.
Well, thank you so much, Christine, for your time today, and look forward to talking to you again in the near future.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.